Hello students, welcome back to our channel. Here we are with another video and today we are going to study the English of class 9th and the book is Beehive. We are going to study chapter number 2, that is the sound of music. There are two parts in this chapter. So we are going to study here the part 2, that is the Shehnai of Bismillah Khan. So let's get started. So there is a little introduction. There are some people, there are some faces given here, and the story says, think of the Shehnai and the first thing you will probably imagine is a wedding or a similar occasion or function. The next would probably be Ustad Bismillah Khan, the Shehnai maestro, playing these instruments. So there are some people and you are being asked, do you know these people, what instruments do they play? So you have to identify the name of the people and you have to identify what musical instrument do they play. So now we are getting back to the story. Emperor Aurangzeb banned the playing of a musical instrument called Pungi in the royal residence, for it had a shrill, unpleasant sound. Pungi became the generic name for reeded noisemakers. Few had thought that it would one day be revived. A barber of a family of professional musicians who had access to the royal palace decided to improve the tonal quality of the Pungi. Here, Pungi is a musical instrument which was played that time in the royal court of Aurangzeb. He chose a pipe with a natural hollow stem that was longer and broader than the Pungi, and made 7 holes on the body of the pipe. When he played on it, closing and opening some of these holes, soft and melodious sounds were produced. He played the instruments before royalty and everyone was impressed. The instrument, so different from the Pungi, had to be given a new name. As the story goes, since it was first played in the Shah's chamber and was played by a Nai, so the instrument was named Shehnai. So this was the first paragraph of this story. So in the royal court of Aurangzeb, there was a musical instrument. I want to tell you that in the royal courts earlier, before the independence, the Rajas and Maharajas and Emperors, they have a hobby of playing musical instruments in their courts. So did the Aurangzeb. So there was a musical instrument named Pungi. So it was played, but the sound of that instrument was not pleasant at all. It was making people uncomfortable. It was not playing good. So the Aurangzeb banned this musical instrument. But a barber family who was musician from generation to generation, they decided to improvise it, to renew it, to make some changes in the Pungi. So they made a long hollow stem and made 7 holes, and then they played by opening and closing the holes one after another. So it produced a melodious sound. It improvised, it renewed the tune of the Pungi. So this musical instrument was new and it pleased everyone. So a name was to be given to this new musical instrument. So since it was played in the Shah's court, Shah, I must write it so that you can understand. Shah court. Shah is an Urdu word that means emperor, that means king. And Nai, as I said, Nai that means barber. So I mentioned it earlier that a barber family who was musician, they improvised, they renewed the Pungi. So combinedly it became the name Shehnai. Shah, that means Shah's court, that means king's court. And then Nai, that means barber. Together it was named Shehnai. Now we are in the second paragraph. The sound of the Shehnai began to be considered auspicious. Auspicious, that means good, that means lucky. And for this reason, it is still played in temples and in the indispensable component of any North Indian wedding. In the past, the Shehnai was part of the Naubat or traditional ensemble of 9 instruments found at the royal courts. Till recently, it was used only in temples and weddings. The credit for bringing these instruments onto classical stage goes to Ustad Bismillah Khan. So earlier than that, it was not as much popular. But the Bismillah Khan, he discovered the new tunes, the new ragas of the Shehnai, and it became very popular in all across the country and abroad. It was now played in temples, and if you are in North India, it is a must ceremony in each and every wedding. If there is a wedding in North India, you can easily hear the Shehnai, which is being played in the wedding ceremony. And it was as much recognized that in the royal courts there were 9 kind of musical instruments, and the Shehnai was one of them. As a 5-year-old, Bismillah Khan played Gilli Danda near a pond in the ancient estate of Dumrao in Bihar. He would regularly go to the nearby Biharij temple to sing the Bhojpuri Chaita, at the end of which he would earn a big laddu weighing 1.25 kg, a prize given by the local Maharaja. This happened 80 years ago, and a little boy has travelled far to earn the highest civilian award in India, the Bharat Ratna. So in India, we have the highest civilian award called Bharat Ratna. So he was conferred the award. He was recognized such a great civilian and such an asset to the nation that the government had decided to confer the highest civilian award, that is Bharat Ratna. But the journey began 80 years ago when he was a 5-year-old boy. That time he was not playing Shehnai, he was playing Gilli Danda, that is a street game popular in villages. So where he was living? He was living near Dumrao. Very often he went to the temple to sing Chaita. Chaita is a kind of devotional song which is often played or often sung in temples. So his voice was very, very pleasing. So the Maharaja of Dumrao used to give him 1.25 kgs of sweet or laddus in prize. Born on 21 March 1916, Bismillah belongs to a well-known family of musicians from Bihar. His grandfather Rasul Bakhsh Khan was the Shehnai Nawaz of the Bhojpur King's Court. His father, Paigambar Bakhsh, and other paternal ancestors were also great Shehnai players. So this was a tradition in his family. So the ancestors, the generation after generation, they used to play the musical instruments, especially the Shehnai. I must mention his grandfather Rasul Bakhsh Khan was the Shehnai Nawaz of Bhojpur King's Court. Bhojpur is a district in Bihar. And his father also, the Paigambar Bakhsh, he was also a well-known and renowned Shehnai player. So this was the fourth paragraph. So now here we are in fifth paragraph. The young boy took to music early in life. At the age of 3, when his mother took him to his maternal uncle's house is in Banaras, now Varanasi. Bismillah was fascinated watching his uncle practice the Shehnai. Soon, Bismillah started accompanying his uncle Ali Bakhsh to the Vishnu temple of Banaras, where Bakhsh was employed to play the Shehnai. Ali Bakhsh would play the shehnai and Bismillah would sit captivated for hours on end. Slowly he started getting lessons in playing the instrument and would sit practicing throughout the day. For years to come, the temple of Balaji and Mangala Maiya and the banks of the Ganga became the young apprentice's favorite haunts where he could practice in solitude. The flowing waters of the Ganga inspired him to improvise and invent ragas that were earlier considered to be beyond the range of the shehnai. So when he was 3 years old, his mother took him to his maternal uncle in Varanasi. Earlier it was called Benares. And he was so fascinated watching his uncle playing the shehnai that he became fond of it. He also tried to learn it, and later on he started practicing with his uncle. Two temples are mentioned here. The first one is Balaji and the second one is Mangala Maiya. They both are on the bank of Ganga in Varanasi. They are very famous. So while watching the river Ganga, he discovered many ragas, that means many tunes of shehnai that was otherwise impossible for anyone else. It was only the Bismillah Khan who discovered new tunes, new ragas while watching the Ganga and sitting on the banks. Now we are in sixth paragraph. At the age of 14, Bismillah accompanied his uncle to the Allahabad Music Conference. At the end of his recital, Ustad Fayaz Khan patted the young boy's back and said, "Work hard and you shall make it." With the opening of the All India Radio in Lucknow in 1938 came Bismillah's big break. He soon became an often heard shehnai player on the radio. So up to now he was not recognized by the many people in India. But at the age of 14, when he went to Allahabad Music Conference with his uncle, there a famous Ustad Fayaz Khan patted him and said that you are different. Just try hard and be determined, focus whatever you are doing and you will be famous one day. In 1938, All India Radio was established and here he got the big break. That means here he got name, fame and everything. So very often his programs, his shehnai was played on All India Radio and everybody all across the India, the people of India used to listen the shehnai of Ustad Bismillah Khan through the All India Radio. Paragraph 7. When India gained independence on 15 August 1947, Bismillah Khan became the first Indian to greet the nation with his shehnai. He poured his heart out into Rag Kafi from the Red Fort to an audience which included Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, who later gave his famous Tryst with Destiny speech. So, here, after independence on 15th August 1947, when the first Prime Minister Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru was about to give the first speech of independence, there also Ustad Bismillah Khan was playing a concert, playing a music. And the rag he played there was Rag Kafi from the Red Fort. And the audience was enthralled with the music, with the tune. Paragraph number 8. Bismillah Khan has given many memorable performances both in India and abroad. His first trip abroad was to Afghanistan, where King Zahir Shah was so taken in by the maestro that he gifted him priceless Persian carpets and other souvenirs. So the first international concert for Bismillah Khan was to Afghanistan. There the King Zahir Shah, who was the King of Afghanistan, was taken away, was enthralled, was stood spellbound with the performance of Bismillah Khan, that he gifted many things, many gifts as a memory, one of which was beautiful and priceless Persian carpets. The king of Afghanistan was not only one to be fascinated with Bismillah Khan's music. Film director Vijay Bhatt was so impressed after hearing Bismillah play at a festival that he named a film after the instrument called Goonj Uthi Shehnai. There was also a film director of that time which was very famous. His name was Vijay Bhatt. He was also very impressed that he made a film over the Shehnai and its name was Goonj Uthi Shehnai. The film was a hit and one of Bismillah Khan's compositions, Dil Ka Khilona Hai Toot Gaya. It was the name of the song. It was hit that time. Turned out to be a nationwide chart buster. It was famous all across the country. Despite this huge success in the celluloid world, Bismillah Khan's venture in film music were limited to two. That means in his entire career, he worked for only two films. The one was this, Goonj Uthi Shehnai, and the other was a Kannad movie, a South movie, Sanadi Appanna. And he said, Bismillah Khan said, I can't come to terms with the artificially and glamour of the field world. That means I cannot adjust here. This world, this glamorous world, I do not belong to this. I am fine on the bank of Ganges. Paragraph number 9. Awards and recognition came thick and fast. Bismillah Khan became the first Indian to be invited to perform at the prestigious Lincoln Center Hall in the United States of America. He also took part in the World Exposition in Montreal, in the Cannes Art Festival and in the Osaka Trade Fair. So there are many international shows, I just named them, in which Bismillah Khan performed. So well known did he become internationally that an auditorium in Tehran was named after him, Tahar Muzik Ustad Bismillah Khan. He was so famous in abroad that in Tehran, a stadium was named after him and the name of the stadium was Tahar Muzik Ustad Bismillah Khan. Paragraph number 10. National awards like Padma Shri, the Padma Bhushan and the Padma Bhushan were conferred on him. So there are three main awards, Padma Shri, Padma Bhushan and Padma Vibhushan. They all were conferred on him and as I said in the beginning of the story that the highest civilian award Bharat Ratna was also conferred on him. In 2001, Ustad Bismillah Khan was awarded India's highest civilian award, the Bharat Ratna, with the coveted award resting on his chest and his eyes glinting with rare happiness. He said, all I would like to say is teach your children music. This is Hindustan's richest tradition. Even the West is now coming to learn our music. He was so happy, but he said nothing. He just said a few lines, out of which were, teach your children Indian music, Indian classical music. This is the tradition of our country. This is so popular and this is so peaceful that the other countries are following us, that the people of other countries are coming to India to learn our music, but we are not paying attention to it. So he requested the parents, the mother and the father, to teach the young children Indian traditional and classical music. Paragraph number 12. In spite of having traveled all over the world, Khan Sahab, as he is fondly called, very fondly he is called Khan Sahab, in exceedingly fond of Banaras and Dumrao, and they remain for him the most wonderful towns of the world. So he has traveled many cities, many countries all across the world, but there are two places that are in the heart of Bismillah Khan. The one is Banaras, that means Varanasi, and the other is Dumrao. He can find peace nowhere but in two cities only. A student of his once wanted him to head a Shehnai school in the USA, and the student promised to recreate the atmosphere of Banaras by replicating the temples there. But Khan Sahab asked him if he would be able to transport River Ganga as well. He was so modest that once a man, one of his students, offered him to open a Shehnai School in United States of America. And he also promised that if you are liking the two cities, the Banaras and Dumrao this much, I will create a replica. Replica that means duplicate. I will create replicating all the temples. That means I will create an atmosphere full of temples there. You will feel like you are in your hometown Banaras. But he denied, saying that if you can carry the river Ganga also, I am coming with you. Otherwise, it is impossible for me to leave Banaras. He was so modest and such a big fan of the old city Banaras and the river Ganga. Later, he is remembered to have said, "That is why whenever I am in a foreign country, I keep yearning to see Hindustan. While in Mumbai, I think of only Banaras and the holy Ganga. And while in Banaras, I miss the unique Matha of Dumrao." So he said, whenever I am abroad, whenever I am the other big cities of India, I think of Banaras and River Ganga. And when I am in Banaras, I miss the Matha of the Dumrao. Matha is a kind of sour drink which is made out of curd. And now we are in last paragraph. Ustad Bismillah Khan's life is a perfect example of the rich cultural heritage of India. One that effortlessly accepts that a devout Muslim like him can very naturally play the Shehnai every morning at the Kashi Vishwanath temple. So Kashi Vishwanath temple is a very famous temple in Banaras. People from all over the India and from abroad also, they come to visit, they come to see this temple. And he has been given as an example, he has been set an example that despite of being a devout Muslim, devout that means here it is written, believing strongly in a religion and obeying its laws and following its practices. That means he was a devout Muslim, but despite of being a devout Muslim, every day he used to play the Shehnai in the Kashi Vishwanath temple. So he has been set as an example for many Indians, that this is our culture, this is our tradition, we have diversity, but still we are united. That's why we call it Incredible India and Unity in Diversity. Ustad Bismillah Khan passed away on 21st August 2006 at the age of 90 after a prolonged illness. He was given a state funeral and the government of India declared one day of national mourning. National mourning, that means it is called in Hindi Rashtriya Shok. So when he died on 21st of August 2006, he was 90 years old and he was very ill from a long time. So when he died, he was given a state funeral. This is a kind of respect you can give whenever somebody dies. This is a some popular person or some person who are of great significance for the country, for the nation. If they die, the state or the country gives them a funeral or a national mourning. So he was giving a state funeral also, and he was given a national mourning also for one day. So this was the story about Ustad Bismillah Khan. This was a biography of Ustad Bismillah Khan. A short biography rather. He was such a talented person, he was such an experienced person, such a cultural person. He has as much as we describe about him would be very less for him. So this was a short biography for him. And I hope you enjoyed, you understood the story. Still, if you have any kind of question, any kind of doubt, you can write that in the comment box. We will be available with a new video again. Thank you very much for watching our videos. If you haven't subscribed our channel, please subscribe our channel, like our videos and share our videos. Till then, goodbye and stay tuned.